Thanks for laying on.
If there's any way we can kind of start some trouble in, with the postseason with them or with anybody, we're going to try our best to do it. We're going to come out tomorrow with a lot of intensity and hopefully get a series win.
The game tonight was...
Last night we had some chances to kind of tie up or go ahead, and we didn't really take advantage, but tonight we did it when it mattered. Sean pitched a great game, and you got tip for cap. The pitchers did a great job. Once we got the lead, they held it.
Wasn't too worried. Sean was kind of commanding the zone. He had good stuff tonight. We knew we were going to get some hits. I mean, we're not just going to roll over once we get down one. Yeah, the season's coming to an end, but we're not going to let that affect us. And we jumped back on them. It was a fun win.
So you beat Georgia Tech and Florida both this week. Is that at least?
It's awesome. I mean, it's always good when you can come out and beat rivals, ACC and SEC. And hopefully we can come out and do the same thing.
How you're playing Florida, no matter what you're playing for, it's always a good time. And we're going to go out there and compete no matter what. SEC tournament is unfortunate. We didn't make it, but we still got one more game to get the series against the Gators. No, I think it's kind of a thing like Georgia Tech. Like, no matter what our records are, we come out and play. So anytime you play the Gators, it's definitely one. Records are pushed aside, and you just go there and compete. It's definitely, I mean, definitely a goal of our teams to win the Tech series, and hopefully we can beat Florida tomorrow, and that'd be a big one to get the series against them, because we haven't had an SEC series yet. So hopefully we pulled a couple of good double plays, and just once I got out of my funk in the second and third inning of throwing balls, threw more strikes, and when you throw strikes, defense make plays, and you don't give up runs. So definitely one of the things I need to do better, and we're going to work upon that. Double play is one of those things in baseball that as a pitcher, you throw a pitch, try and execute it to get them in ground ball, and when you get it, it's one of the huge confidence builder.
I mean, win the series with Tech, and at least we got an opportunity to win a series against Florida. And something we hadn't done in a long time. And really proud of Sean. Pitched great. And Hunter Cole continues to do some great things, and you can see him growing. And it's set up for him to get where he was scheduled to get. And he's got another year for sure here. And I like his progress. Daniel Nichols finally got a couple hits and a big one. One pretty, but he's been robbed enough that he deserved it. That infield hit and that RBI. So I just really proud of the guys that hung in there, and they don't have anything to play for, but a little bit of pride in each other, and they really rallied well tonight, and we got good relief pitching from Mike Mancuso and Dylan Cole and Nelson doing their deal. They're really good. We knew they were, and it was just fun to see them execute those timely double plays tonight, because I think that really built Sean out, because we, you know, he was throwing the ball really well, but he had some walks those were the only mistakes. That second inning, I mean, first inning was probably the best inning he's had all year. I mean, everything, every spot, I think is about 80-90% strikes, and the balls were by design. As he had three pitches going, and you just felt like, oh wow, he's gonna be really good tonight. And then he has to turn right in the stretch in that second inning, and they did a good job. They made him work, but the double plays bailed him out. He gave us seven great innings, and I was just glad to see that we hung in there long enough. We got a couple mistakes, and we finally took advantage. They're great kids. They're made of the right stuff. We just hadn't, you know, handled those moments as, you know, just too many times. And what had happened, we just got so far behind the eight ball. It's just, it's really difficult to make up the type of ground we had to make up in this league. I mean, you just can't do it. And in a lot of other leagues, and you know, you get the right timing and everything come together. But in this league, it's just, it's really tough to make up the type of ground that we had to make up after we had played so poorly those first four SEC weekends. And it's tough. It was an uphill climb, and we just couldn't do it. Now, we've been right there, but I think last night was a little bit of a microcosm of what we were this year. Just good enough to lose, unfortunately, too many times. And the biggest thing, the most positive thing about it is when you look at it at the end of the day, you see guys like Jared Walsh, Sean McLaughlin, Hunter Cole, Daniel Nichols, Zach Bowers, Nelson Ward. They're all back. I mean, that's where a lot of, I guess, enthusiasm or excitement about them is not only are they finishing, this team's finishing out strong, but you're going to have some really good players and hungry players for some success coming back next year.